fiery ring. Bound by wild desire, I fell into a ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire, the ring of fire. Went right home and I went to bed. I stuck at loving 44 beneath my head. Got up next morning and I grabbed that gun. Took a shot of cocaine and away I run. Made a good run, but I run too slow. They overtook me down in Juarez, Mexico. Laid in the hot joints, taking the pill. In walks the sheriff from Jericho Hill. He said, Willie, your name is not Jack Brown. You're the dirty hack that shot your woman down. Said, yes, so oh, yes, my name is Willie Lee. If you got a warrant, just read it to me. Shot her down because she made me slow. I thought it was her daddy, but she had 5 months. When I was arrested, I was dressed in black. They put me on a train and they took me back. Had no friend for to do my bail. They slapped my dried-up carcass in the county jail. Got up next morning about a 9:30. I spied a sheriff coming down the line. Up then he coughed as he cleared his throat. He said, you dirty hack, into that district court. Into the courtroom a trial began, where I was handled by 12 honest men. Just before the jury started out, I saw that little judge come as to look about. The judge, he smiled as he picked up his pen. 99 years in the Folsom pen. 99 years underneath that ground. I can't forget the day I shot that bad dude down. Come on, you gotta listen unto me. Lay off that whiskey, lick that cocaine bee. Let it be.
Well, I woke up Sunday morning with no way to hold my head. That didn't hurt. And the beer I had for breakfast wasn't bad, so I had one more for dessert. Then I fumbled in my closet, threw my clothes and found my cleanest dirty shirt. And then I washed my face and combed my hair, stumbled down the stairs to meet the day. I smoked my mind the night before with cigarettes and songs I'd been picking. Then I lit my first and watched the small boy cussing at a can that he was kicking. Then I crossed the empty street and caught the Sunday smell of someone frying chicken. And it took me back to something that I lost somewhere, somehow along the way. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, I'm wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. 'Cause there's something in a Sunday that makes the body feel alone. There ain't nothing short of dying, oh, half as lonesome as the sound of a sleeping city sidewalk and Sunday morning coming down. In the park I saw a daddy with a laughing little girl that he was swinging. And then I stopped beside a Sunday school and listened to the songs that they were singing. Then I went on down the road, and somewhere far away a lonely bell was ringing. And it echoed through the canyon like a disappearing dream of yesterday. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, I'm wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. 'Cause there's something in a Sunday that makes a body feel alone. There ain't nothing short of dying half as lonesome as the sound of a sleeping city sidewalk and Sunday morning coming down.
My daddy left home when I was three. Didn't leave very much to my ma and me. Just this old guitar and an empty bottle of booze. Now I don't blame him 'cause he run and hid. But the meanest thing that my daddy ever did was before he left, he went and named me Sue. He must have thought that it was quite a joke, and it got a lot of laughs from lots of folks. Seems I had to fight my whole life through. Some gal would giggle and I'd turn red, and some guy'd laugh and I'd bust his head. I tell you, life ain't easy for a boy named Sue. But I grew up quick and I grew up mean. My fist got hard and my wits got keen. Roamed from town to town to hide my shame. But I made me a vow to the moon and stars, I'd search the honky-tonks and bars and kill that man that gave me that awful name. It was Gatlinburg in mid-July, and I'd just hit town and my throat was dry. Thought I'd stop and have myself a brew. At an old saloon on a street of mud, there at a table dealing stud, sat the dirty mangy dog could name me Sue. Well, I knew that snake was my own sweet dad from a worn-out picture that my mother'd had. I knew that scar on his cheek and his evil eye. He was big and bent and gray and old, and I looked at him and my blood ran cold. I said, my name is Sue. How do you do? Now you're gonna die.
Yeah,
that's what I said. Well, I hit him hard right between the eyes, and he went down, but to my surprise, come up with a knife and cut off a piece of my ear. Then I busted a chair right across his teeth, and we crashed through the wall into the street, kicking and a gouging in the mud and the blood and the beer. Well, I tell you, I fought tougher men, but I really can't remember when. He kicked like a mule and he bit like a crocodile. I heard him laugh and then I heard him cuss, and he went for his gun, but I pulled mine first. He stood there looking at me and I saw him smile. He said, now, son, this world is rough, and if a man's gonna make it, he's gotta be tough. And I knew I wouldn't be there to help you along. So I give you that name, and I said goodbye, and I knew you'd have to get tough or die. And it's that name that helped to make you strong. He said, now, you just fought one hell of a fight, and I know you hate me, and you got the right to kill me now, and I wouldn't blame you if you do. But you ought to thank me before I die for the gravel in your gut and the spit in your eye, 'cause I'm the that named you Sue. What could I do? I got all choked up and I threw down my gun. I called him a paw and he called me son. I come away with a different point of view. And I think about him every now and then, every time I try and every time I win. And if I ever have a boy, I think I'm gonna name him Bill or George, anything but Sue. I still hate that name. What a dirty
anything to...
A young cowboy named Billy Joe grew restless on the farm. A boy filled with wanderlust who really meant no harm. He changed his clothes and shined his boots and combed his dark hair down. And his mother cried as he walked out, "Don't take your guns to town, son. Leave your guns at home, Bill. Don't take your guns to town." Laughed and kissed his mom and said, "You're Billy Joe's a man. I can shoot as quick and straight as anybody can. But I wouldn't shoot without a cause. I'd gun nobody down." But she cried again as he rolled away, "Don't take your guns to town, son. Leave your guns at home, Bill. Don't take your guns to town." Sang a song his only road, his guns hung at his hips. He rode into a cattle town, a smile upon his lips. He stopped and walked into a bar and laid his money down. And his mother's words echoed again, "Don't take your guns to town, son. Leave your guns at home, Bill. Don't take your guns to town." Drank his first strong liquor then to calm his shaking hand. And he tried to tell himself at last he had become a man. A dusty cowpoke at his side began to laugh him down. And his mother's words echoed again, "Don't take your guns to town, son. Leave your guns at home, Bill. Don't take your guns to town." Bill with rage and Billy Joe reached for his gun to draw. But the stranger drew his gun and fired before he even saw. As Billy Joe fell to the floor, the crowd all gathered round and wondered at his final words, "Don't take your guns to town, son. Leave your guns at home, Bill. Don't take your guns to town."
An old cowboy went riding out one dark and windy day. On a ridge he rested as he went along his way. When all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw plowing through the ragged sky and up a cloudy draw. Their brands were still on fire and their hooves were made of steel. The horns were black and shiny, and their hot breath he could feel. A bolt of fear went through him as they thundered through the skies. Saw the riders coming hard, and they heard their mournful cry. Yippee-yi. Catch the devil's herd across. across these endless skies. Yippee-yi-yay.
I left Kentucky back in 49 and went to Detroit working on assembly line. The first year they had me putting wheels on Cadillacs. Every day I'd watch them beauties roll by, and sometimes I'd hang my head and cry, cause I always wanted me one that was long and black. One day I devised myself a plan that should be the envy of most any man. I'd sneak it out of there in the lunchbox in my hand. Now getting caught meant getting fired, but I figured I'd have it all by the time I retired. I'd have me a car worth at least $100,000. I'd get it one piece at a time, and it wouldn't cost me a dime. You'll know it's me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride around in style, I'm gonna drive everybody wild, cause I'll have the only one there is around. The very next day when I checked in with my big lunchbox and with some help of my friends, I left that day with a lunchbox full of gear. Well, I never considered myself a thief, but GM wouldn't miss just one little piece, especially if I strung it out over several years. The first day I got me a fuel pump, the next day I got me an engine and a trunk, then I got me a transmission and all the chrome. The little things I could get in my big lunchbox, like nuts and bolts and all four shocks, the big stuff I snuck out in my buddy's mobile home. Well, up to now, my plan went all right till we tried to put it all together one night. That's when I discovered that something was definitely wrong. The transmission was a 53 and the motor turned out to be a 73. And when we tried to put in the bolts, all the holes were gone. So we drilled it out so that it would fit, and with a little bit of help from an adapter kit, had that engine running just like a song. The headlights, it was another sight. We had two on the left and one on the right, but when we turned out the switch, all three of them come on. Well, the back end looked kind of funny too, but we put it together, and when we got through, that's when we noticed that we only had one tail fin. About that time, my wife walked out, and I could see in her eyes that she had her doubts, but she opened the door and said, "Honey, take me for a spin." So we went uptown just to get the tags, and I headed to ride on down Main Drag. You could hear everybody laughing for blocks around. But up there at the courthouse, they didn't laugh, cause to type it up, it took the whole staff, and when they got through, the title weighed 60 pounds. Got it one piece at a time, and it didn't cost me a dime. You'll know it's me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride around in style, I'm gonna drive everybody wild, cause I'll have the only one there is around. Yeah, Red Rider, this is the Cottonmouth and the Psycho Billy Cadillac. Come on, on. Negatory on the cost of this machine there, Red Rider. You might say that I just went up to the factory there and picked it up. It's cheaper that way. What model is it? Well, it's a 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, automobile.
Texas border town, sat a boy and his guitar, and the people came for miles around, and all the girls from there to Austin were slipping away from home and putting jewelry in hot to take the trip to go and listen to the little dark-haired boy who played the Tennessee flat-top box, and he would play.
make a dime, but give him his guitar, and he'd be happy all the time. And all the girls from 9 to 90 were snapping fingers, tapping toes, and begging him don't stop, and hypnotized and fascinated by the little dark-haired boy who played the Tennessee flat-top box, and he was late. Like the breeze, and they forgot him in the little town, but all the girls still dreamed about him and hung around the cabaret until the doors were locked. And then one day on the hit parade was a little dark-haired boy who played the Tennessee flat-top box, and he would play.
Tell me the time. How much longer will it be till we cross that Mason-Dixon line? At daylight, would you tell that engineer to slow it down? Or better still, just stop the train, cause I want to look around. Hey, porter, hey, porter, what time did you say? How much longer will it be till I can see the light of day? When we hit Dixie, would you tell that engineer to ring his bell? And ask everybody that ain't asleep to stand right up and yell. Oh, Bob Woodward. Marshall Bradford. W.S. Holland on the drums. Hey, porter, hey, porter, it's getting light outside. This old train is puffing smoke and I have to strain my eyes. But ask that engineer if he will blow his whistle, please. Cause I smell frost on cotton leaves and I feel a southern breeze. Hey, porter, hey, porter, please get my bags for me. I need nobody to tell me now that we're in Tennessee. Go tell that engineer to make that lonesome whistle scream. We're not so far from home, so take it easy on the speed. Earl Ball, Jerry Hensley, Jack Hale, and Bob Lewis. Hey, porter, hey, porter, please open up the door. They stop this train, I'm gonna get off first, cause I can't wait no more. Tell that engineer, I said thanks a lot, and I didn't mind the bear. Go and set my feet on southern soil and breathe that southern air. Call him drunken Ira Hayes.
He won't answer anymore.
Not the whiskey-drinking Indian nor the Marine that went to war.
Gather round me, people. There's a story I would tell about a brave young Indian that we should remember well. From the tribe of the Pima Indian, a proud and peaceful band who farmed the Phoenix Valley in Arizona land. Down their ditches for 1,000 years, the waters grew Ira's people's crops, till the white man stole the water rights and the sparkling water stopped. Now Ira's folks were hungry, and their land grew crops of weeds. But when war came, Ira volunteered and forgot the white man's greed. Call him drunken Ira Hayes, he won't answer anymore. Not the whiskey-drinking Indian, nor the Marine that went to war. There they battled up Iwo Jima's hill, 250 men. But only 27 lived to fight back down again. And when that fight was over, and when Old Glory raised, among the men to hold it high was the Indian, Ira Hayes. Call him drunken Ira Hayes, he won't answer anymore. Not the whiskey-drinking Indian, nor the Marine that went to war. Ira Hayes returned a hero, celebrated through the land. He was wined and speeched and honored. Everybody shook his hand. But he was just a Pima Indian. No water, no crops, no chance. At home, nobody cared what Ira had done. And when did the Indians dance? Then Ira started drinking hard. Jail was often his home. There they'd let him raise a flag and lower it like you'd throw a dog a bone. Well, he died drunk early one morning, alone in the land that he fought to save. 2 inches of water in a lonely ditch was the grave for Ira Hayes. Call him drunken Ira Hayes, he won't answer anymore. Not the whiskey-drinking Indian nor the Marine that went to war. Yeah, call him drunken Ira Hayes. But his land is just as dry, and his ghost is lying thirsty in the ditch where Ira died. Ira Hayes. If I were a carpenter and you were a lady, would you marry me anyway? Would you have my baby?
If you were a carpenter, and I were a lady, I'd marry you anyway. I'd have your baby.
Save your love through loneliness. Save your love through sorrow. Gave you my onlyness. Give me your tomorrow. If I were a miller and a mill wheel grinding, would you miss your colored dress and your soft shoes shining?
If you were a miller and a mill wheel grinding, I'd miss my colored dress or my soft shoes shining.
Save your love through loneliness. Save your love through sorrow. Gave you my onlyness, give me your tomorrow. If a tinker was my trade, would I still find you?
I'd be carrying the pots you made, following behind you.
If I worked my hand in wood, would you still love me?
I'd answer you, yes I would.
Would you not be above me? Save your love through loneliness. Save your love through sorrow. Gave you my onlyness. Give me your tomorrow.
Out your window when I'm leaving, I won't even turn my head. And don't send no kin folks to give me no talking. I'll be gone like I said. You'd say the same old thing you've been saying all along. Just lay there in your bed and keep your mouth shut till I'm gone. Don't give me that old familiar crying, cuss and moan. Understand, yo man, you you better listen to me, honey. Understand your man. Give my other suit to the Salvation Army, and everything else I leave behind. I ain't taking nothing that'll slow down my traveling while I'm untangling my mind. And I ain't gonna repeat what I said anymore. I'll be off breathing air that ain't been ever breathed before. And I'm gonna get as gone as a wild goose in winter. Then you'll understand, your man. Meditate on it. Understand, your man. You hear me talking, honey? Understand, your man. But remember what I told you. Understand, your man. Your man.
Blues, come on, get rhythm. When you get the blues, get a rock and roll feeling in your bones, put taps on your toes and get gone, get rhythm. When you get the blues, a little shoeshine boy never gets low down, got the dirtiest job in town, bending low at the people's feet on a windy corner of the dirty street. Well, I asked him while he shined my shoes how to keep from getting the blues. Grand as he raised his little head, he popped his shoeshine ragged. Then he said, get rhythm. When you get the blues, come on, get rhythm. When you get the blues, get a rock and roll feeling in your bones, put taps on your toes, get gone, get rhythm. When you get the blues. Come on, get rhythm. When you get the blues, get a rock and roll feeling in your bones, put taps on your toes and get gone, get rhythm. When you get the blues. Well, I sat and listened to the shoeshine boy, and I thought I was gonna jump with joy. Slapped on a shoe polish left and right. He took his shoeshine rag and he held it tight. He stopped once to wipe the sweat away. I said, you mighty little boy to be working that way. He said, I like it, with a big wide grin. He kept on a popping and he said again, get rhythm. When you get the blues, come on, get rhythm. When you get the blues, get a rock and roll feeling in your bones, put taps on your toes and get gone, get rhythm. When you get the blues.
Well, you asked me if I'll forget my baby. I guess I will someday. I don't like it, but I guess things happen that way. You asked me if I'll get along. I guess I will some way. I don't like it, but I guess things happen that way. God gave me that girl to lean on, then he put me on my own. Heaven help me be a man and have the strength to stand alone. I don't like it, but I guess things happen that way. Well, you asked me if I'll miss her kisses. I guess I will every day. I don't like it, but I guess things happen that way.
You ask me if I'll find another. I don't know, I can't say. I don't like it, but I guess things happen that way. God gave me that girl to lean on, then he put me on my own. Heaven help me be a man and have the strength to stand alone. I don't like it, but I guess things happen that way.
Here's a Bob Dylan song June and I recorded.
A long time ago.
Go away from my window. Leave at your own chosen speed. I'm not the one you want, babe. I'm not the one you need. You say you're looking for someone who's never weak, but always strong, to protect you and defend you, whether you are right or wrong. Someone to open each and every door. Each time you call, and it will love you for your life and nothing more. But it ain't me, babe. No, 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 it ain't me, babe. It ain't me you're looking for, babe. You say you're looking. Clark, Roy plays the guitar.
who's there?
Cargo.
Cargo who?
Cargo.
Beep, beep. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Horgo.
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 Hey, I talk about rambling. She's the fastest train on the line. Hey, talk about rambling. She's the fastest train on the line. That's that orange blossom special rolling down a seaboard line. Tonight we have a special show featuring comedy and country music. Country people not only have their own kind of music, they also have their own kind of humor, and good humor it is. So sit back and enjoy a laugh country style. Well, there once was a musical troupe, a kickin' singin' folk group. They sang the mountain ballads and the folk songs of our land. They were long on musical ability. Folks thought they would go far, but political incompatibility led to their downfall. Well, the one on the right was on the left, and the one in the middle was on the right, and the guy on the left was in the middle, and the guy in the rear was a Methodist. Hey, GC3 and Carly. Well, the curtain had ascended, a hush fell on the crowd, as thousands there were gathered to hear the folk songs of our land. The but they took their politics seriously that night at the concert hall. As the audience watched deliriously, they had a free-for-all. Well, the one on the left was on the bottom, and the guy in the middle was on the top, and the guy on the left got a broken arm, and the guy on his rear said, oh dear. Bum, bum, bum. Hey, well, this should be a lesson. If you plan to start a folk group, to don't go mixing politics with the folk songs of our land. Just work on harmony and diction, and play your banjo well. And if you have political convictions, keep them to yourself. Well, the one on the right works in a bank, and the guy in the middle drives a truck. The guy on the left's an all-night DJ, and the one in the rear got drafted. I remember when I was a lad, times were hard and things were bad. There's a silver lining behind every cloud. Just poor people, that's all we were, trying to make a living out of black land. We'd get together in a family circle singing loud. Daddy sang bass.
Mama sang tenor.
Me and little brother would join right in there.
Cause singing seems to help a troubled soul. One of these days it won't be long, I'll rejoin them in a song. I'm gonna join the family circle at the throne. Oh no, the circle won't be broken. By and by, Lord, by and by. Daddy sang bass.
Mama sang tenor.
And little brother would join right in there.
In the sky, Lord, in the sky. I remember after work, Mama would call in all of us. You could hear us singing for a country mile. Now little brother's done gone on, but I'll rejoin him in a song. We'll be together again up yonder in a little while. Daddy sang bass.
Mama sang tenor.
Me and little brother would join right in there.
Cause singing seems to help a troubled soul. One of these days it won't be long, I'll rejoin them in a song. I'm gonna join the family circle at the throne. Oh no, the circle won't be broken. By and by, Lord, by and by.
Daddy sang bass.
Mama sang tenor.
Me and little brother would join right
in the sky, Lord, in the sky. Because you understand it. Every single thing I try to do, you're always there to lend a helping hand. But most of all, I love you 'cause you're you. No matter what may be the style or season, I know your love will always see me through. I love you for 100,000 reasons, but most of all, I love you 'cause you're you.
my love to Rose, please won't you, mister? Take her all my money, tell her to buy some pretty clothes. Tell my boy that Daddy's so proud of him. And don't forget to give my love to Rose. Tell them I said thanks for waiting for me. Tell my boy to help his mom at home. Tell my Rose to try to find another, 'cause it ain't right that she should live alone. Mister, here's the bag with all my money. Bless you for finding me this morning. Now don't forget to give my love to Rose. Give my love to Rose, please won't you, mister? Take her all my money, tell her to buy some pretty clothes. Tell my boy that Daddy's so proud of him. And don't forget to give my love to...